on the first column and department inside the second column. Okay, so this is what is happening when you do like this. Okay, yeah? So meaning that you have two columns of your table, two column of table. And then it is a many-to-many relationship, means that one name can appear in many departments, okay? Meaning that you can have same or two staff with the same name appear in one department, and one department can have means that this same name, maybe you can have, let's say, Alex here and Alex here in same department and so on. So you can have, but different people, okay, different people. Because here we didn't consider the primary key yet. We just say it's many to many, like that. But later when you consider primary key, you are not going to go for many to many already. You are going to go, normally will be function already. Okay, so here we just don't consider that one. We just consider Alex here in this department. Alex also, the name of Alex also appear in another department, but because you have two Alex. Because we have to consider this is a set, you cannot duplicate the data inside your set. Okay? So that is what you mean by this one. Okay, so when you do this, this is what you mean by that. Okay, when you declare your variable DEPT or department here, okay, this is what you mean by that. Without the record yet. Means that you just declare a variable. That's all. That is the meaning of your state space. But this state space is the one that something like you want to do storing of records later. So that's why you need the variable inside your state space. Because later you are going to store your data inside your database. How to store. So all this will be used for all the variable use will be from your state space. Okay, so initial state here, I think all of you know how to do initial state. Okay, so because if you have gone through the tutorial, okay, you should know how to do this one already. Okay, you should know on how to do this one already. So first of all, remember, every time you do state space, on top here, okay, must put the state space name. That is the first thing that you have to remember. So in our case here is department. Okay, only the initial state will not have delta or z. Okay, you just put the department like this. No need to put delta or z notation. Okay, for the initial state without that. And then after that, okay, what you have to do, you take the variable from your state space, you put here. Okay, then because this is, even though you have a relationship, two different types, and when you want to say that the department is empty, you don't need to put empty set method to empty set. You don't need to do that. Just put one empty set is enough. Because empty set means empty already. So if it is empty, even though you put one empty name or department, automatically there will be nothing inside your database. Okay, so just put equals to empty set. That's all. Okay, so I hope that this one, you already know how to put this one, because initial state will be the easiest one to do. Okay, so that is initial state. Okay, so most of the time, from your assignment also, you are going to do CRUD. Okay, that is the normal one that you have to do, CRUD. So in this question, also in the tutorial, there will be CRUD also. But of course, in the tutorial also, I just put add and remove, but you can actually do yourself how to update, okay, and then how to override and so on. But here also, if you want me to show, I can show you how to override, how to update and so on, and display the information also. Okay, so let's say you want to add information, add entry to your database where you want to assign a new name to a new department. Okay, maybe you have a new staff join in, And then you want to make sure that this stuff belongs to this department, for example. Okay? But in this case, but if let's say you have to remember, because if let's say the data, even though you have two different staff, but two same name, same department, you cannot duplicate the data. Means that you can have that record once only in your database only. But now we want to make sure that this staff name and this department does not exist yet in your system. Okay, so how to add that? Can I not remove using this? Sometimes, on off. Can you hear me? Okay, so let's say I want to add, okay, a new name, a new staff into the system, and then I need to assign this to, of course, the department inside the system. Okay? So, add entry. So, as I told you just now, first thing is when you do, it doesn't matter operation schema or you have to put your state space name on top. That is the first thing that you have to do it. Okay, so after you put the state space name here, you are linking this operation with your state space ready. Okay, so after that, you have to ask yourself when you want to add a new staff into the system, you have to ask yourself whether, okay, this additional information here will have an update to your database. That is the first thing that the second thing that you have to think about. Okay, so if there is an update to your database, so what is the symbol that you have to do? Delta symbol. So where to put? You put in front of the state space name. Okay, so you put delta. Okay, when you put delta here, meaning that you are telling people with this operation, there will be an update to your database. That is the storytelling here. This single line means that you are telling other people there is an update to your database. That's all. You just tell like that. You don't know what update yet. You don't really know. You just tell people that from this operation schema, there is an update to your database. That's all. Okay? So now, what will be the update that you want to do? Of course, you have to have the input. Because if you want to update something, you need to have something to be updated or what? You need some input here. So that's why in this question, we were given name and department. The name will be name and department. Okay, so you have two input that we want to add. Okay. Why do you think we need these two input when we want to add entry into our system? What do you think we need these two? Why do you think? Why not name on it? Why not department on it? Why need two input? Why do you think we need two input? Normally last week you learned only one input, right? One input, one input, one input. So now why two input? Why do you think we need two input? Why do you think? Because, okay, you refer back everything, you refer back to your state space. You go to your state space, you want one table, yeah, consists of what? Name and department, right? So, can you add data with a name only? For this one, no. In this question, in this scenario, if you want to add the record, you must add both records. Name and both records. You cannot just simply add name, but without the department. So you have to add both records. So when you want to add both records, meaning that you need to have name and also department information. Okay, so both data needed. That's why you need both input. Okay, so inside your system. Okay, so that's why here you need both. Okay, so that is the reason. Yeah, that is the reason. So now, when I want to actually do checking, so can I do checking? Okay, can I make it for example, is it possible for me to check only the name in the system or department on the inside the system? Because now it is a many-to-many relationship. So you have to think about this relationship. It is a many-to-many. Means that if I want to check whether the name already exists in the database, yes, can exist, because you can have Alex already exist, but you want to add another Alex into the system. And then if I want to say that department, is it already exists or not exists, you can either do same thing, whether it exists or not exists. Because if, let's say you have a department, let's say faculty, like our department, like department of software engineering and technology, department of information system and security, all those same department. So you can have same department already exist, and you may not have the department exist yet. So it's other way. Okay, either way for this case. So it won't be confusing if you want to do exist member of or not member of, because contradict your precondition. Okay, because if you want to do individually, because if this is many-to-many relationship, you have to consider that. So in order for you to solve the problem, you check your whole record. Means that combining your domain and range as a whole record, whether exists or not, you understand enough? Meaning that in this case, you go back to your state space, you have name and department there. So how to do that? You just put name, okay, maplet, because now we are talking about data, okay? So maplet is the data, the symbol that you have to use, and then go for department. So I am checking this and this, whether exists or not. The whole report here, whether exists in my database. Okay? So in order for me to add new entry, this record cannot exist in my database. Because remember, when it comes to set normally, okay, you don't duplicate the same record. Okay? You don't duplicate. So it means that this record, of course, name can be the same for others, but maybe different department. Okay? That's why we cannot check one by one. One domain, whatever. But you have to record as, you have to check as a whole. Okay? So in this case, you do not a member of. So, because we are involving two domain and range, two data here. So we just say department. Here, department. Because this department is actually name and department as a record. So you just put a member, not a member of. Okay? You are checking inside that database. So that database name is department. So because you are putting two data together, straight away you just check with that whole thing. Yeah? And after that, nothing, So you don't, because this one no capacity, whatever, then you can update your database. So how to update your database? That is your variable from your state space. Put run equals to department. Same like what you did previously. Okay, when you want to update, and you put this one. Now, your department consists of name and department together. Okay? So name and department together, meaning that in these curly braces, you have to put these two data together. Okay? You cannot put only one record, you have to put two data together. This is how you add your data into your database. This is how you add the data into your database. Okay? So this is add entry. So same thing for remove entry. Okay, just terbalik lah. Just that for remove entry. Okay. So for remove entry, this, if you want to remove the data mask at this, and then this one you put back. Okay, so update, you put override, just change the symbol. Okay, display, then you have to display only one by one for now. Okay, so that is actually how you do something like CRUG. Okay, so you have to make sure that. Okay, now let's say, okay, let's say I want to remove one department. This department does not exist anymore in my system. Let's say our department, this set is our Department of Software Engineering Technology. Rename become Department of Software Engineering. So no more technology at the back, for example. Rename. So we have to remove this set from our database. We maybe have D, C, E, W, for example. That is the new name. Okay? So we want to remove this set. Okay? I want to remove. But now, I want to remove the record. All the stuff, all the name, from this department. So remove the whole record. Not one by one. This one remove one by one. But I just give, I have input of one. Okay, I have one input of one department. Okay, so how do you think you can do that? How do you want to remove the whole thing? Let's say I want to remove. Okay, I copy this one. Remove department. Doesn't matter under me or under contributed. Cannot, right? Why? Why? Because your department just now consists of two. We got set two column lah. But here D is one. So cannot, cannot do this. Okay? So how to make sure that we can make it correct? Then you look back at this one. You look back at your state space. Okay, in this case, D is department, DPT, yeah? So, between this, domain or range. First or second coordinates. Second coordinate we call as range data. So, in order to have that, we put range. Okay? So, we are telling people that I have D here. You just check with the range data only. No need to check with the domain. Check with the range. Okay, so that's what you mean by this. Okay, that's what. So when you do, that's what you learn down, range, all those things. This is the purpose. This is the purpose. Okay, so when your record is only one, you have to know whether it's domain or range. But this one, you have both. You have both. So you just look at the whole table. That's why you just check with. Okay, but in this case, I have only the domain, the range. Okay, so I cannot check the domain because I don't have the record for it. So I have to check with the range on D. So how to do that? You just put range. Okay, meaning that I have the department here. So name is domain, department here is range. So I am checking. Okay, now how to retrieve the record from the range? How to remove the record from the range? Just now we want to remove, we use this. Right. Yeah? So now, how to remove with the range data? You remember what you have learned last week? Yeah. You remember what is the symbol for that? what is the symbol? When you have the range data. Is either range restriction or range anti-restriction. Okay, so these two only. You have the range data, is either range restriction or range anti-restriction. If you want to remove, should be range restriction or range anti-restriction? Anti-restriction. Okay, meaning that you have to go for this symbol. Okay? Range anti-restriction. So how to write this? Okay, how to write this? So I just give you the statement first. How to actually remove the record? So we have to refer to our database. This is our database. So you go for this one, then you do this. So this is actually how you remove the whole record related to this document. But when you remove, you are going to update your database also. So in front of you, you just put department prime equals to like. So automatically, whatever record that have this kind of range data will be removed from your database. And then the updated of your database will be without this department. Okay, so that's how you actually update your database.
away, but we will go for another question first. Okay, so this is actually how you update your or remove the report. So remember, every time you have only one data, okay, you cannot use backslash. You cannot use backslash. Backslash is both default, both data. Now you have one data only, you have to use whatever symbols that you have learned previously. Okay, you have learned previously. So it means that you have to make sure that you know what you want to remove or you want to add whatever. Add normally make all the information, but remove, update,
produce a result, no input involved. Even though you want to produce
car park, available space, all those things, there's no input before. You just use formula this minus this, that's all. Okay, but now, in this case, you have an input involved. Okay? When you have an input involved, you have to tell the people that there is no update to your database. You have to tell. This is a must. So in this case, you have to put another additional line. You have to put department front equals to department. So this is what we call as remain unchanged error. Range restriction or I didn't show anything yet. I just want to know what will be the output that I get if I do range restriction. Okay, have any report? What? Huh? Your report will be single data or two data? Like two columns or one column? When you do like this? Two columns of report, huh? The answer that you get here will be name department will be this set. For example, I'm searching for this set department. I have A under this set, C under this set, F under this set, and then X under this set. For example, that is the record that I will have. So it means that the record that I will receive is two data. Domain and range, as the answer. Okay, this is what I will get. Okay, so if I assign to name here, is this correct or not? Not correct. Why not correct? Because name. Here you will have both name. Department. So, if you want to share to show only name, domain or range will be the
domain.
So you put dom. Relational dimension. Huh? Ken, what is actually relational dimension? to search for this. Can I use the rationale? Yes, even though relational image, you search domain data, but you can combine with inverse. Yeah, you can combine with inverse. How to do that? Yeah, I just give you another example, another answer. You can do names, output. the staff name and the problem does not exist in the system, the reply is no. So means that these two should be together, must come together. So you have to put the symbol conjunction. Conjunction means and. Okay, conjunction means and. So your variable is reply equals to no is the one that you take. Either you do like this or you do. Okay? So that is actually how you actually use your whatever that you learned from last lecture to be implemented in your office. Example only, this one is similar to your tutorial. So when you discuss tutorial, I hope that you understand, I hope that you can understand clearer when either me or Ms. Kandinda discuss the tutorial. Okay, so at least you have a little bit of knowledge how to use the symbol from last tutorial. Okay, any question I'm here? Any question I'm here? Okay, understand? Okay, so it's either this one, you put bracket here, or you put here, or you should put here. It's the same thing. Okay, remember, if one input involved, even though it's actually remain unchanged operation, you have to put remain unchanged. You have to keep it. If remain unchanged or query schema, but no input, not the output, no need input. Like what you did last week, no input involved. In your space available, your car park, whatever, there's no input. So that's why I didn't put in your hand. If you put no problem, it's not an error, it's not needed. So if you put, it's not needed. You want to put this one? And no problem. Because it's all, the arrangement is not yours. Normally I will put the last one because I want to show the condition, what we want first. Okay, but it's actually, it doesn't matter, the arrangement is not. Because all are and. Okay, and so it doesn't matter that. Okay, any question, Auntie here? Okay, I think we take a few minutes break. bigger one.